Hey streamers, and welcome back to our YouTube channel. So in this video, I'll be talking about OBS Studio and how to use it to go live with WpStream. So we've previously created one of these videos, but we've recently had some updates with OBS Studio, so I will let you know what those updates are. So as you know, OBS Studio is a free pro tool that you can use to broadcast live events. But let's get started with how to set up a channel on WpStream. So as you know, you will have to install the WpStream plugin, then you can sign in through the credentials sections and then go to all channels. Here we'll want to create a new free to view channel. As you can see, it's just like creating a post or a page on your WordPress website. I'm giving a title to my channel and I'm also leaving a description. And I'll also add a featured image because we want to set up our live stream to look as nice as possible and to have as much text or relevant content as possible. So I'm setting up categories as well, tags, media categories and things like that, because we also want to help with the video SEO. And I'll link the video to our video SEO tips and tricks so that you can check it out. You then publish the channel, and before you turn on, you will need to go to channel settings, and here you can either enable record live stream, display viewer account, lock to website, or any of these other settings. So you can choose whatever you want, and once you're done, you turn on your channel. I have skipped forward as it is turning on. This might take about a minute or two, so you'll have to be patient. Once your channel is on, you can go ahead and start streaming, where you can go live through your browser or you can go live with an external streaming app. As you can see, I'm using OBS. We've talked about this at the start of the video, so make sure you pick OBS Studio. There's a server and stream key, and we will add those to specific sections on OBS Studio. So let's go to settings. Under settings, you'll want to go to the stream section. We're over here. And under service, it is currently on custom, but we'll want to click on show all and scroll down to the bottom until you find WpStream. So choose WpStream, and for the server, you can either choose the closest server, which is automatic, or any other servers. Go back, copy the stream key from WpStream and paste it over here on OBS Studio and click on OK. Once you've done that, click on Start Streaming. Go back, exit the settings, and click on View Channel. This will take you straight to your channel with your live stream. So I'm scrolling down and I will click on the play button so that I can start watching. So here is my live stream. I can go full screen, go picture in picture, and just enjoy the experience of watching the live stream. So once you're done with your live stream, you can simply head back to OBS Studio. And here you'll click on Stop Streaming. If you go back to the page, you'll see that the live stream will stop and the following message will appear. So that's how you know your live stream is over. And that is basically it on how to go live on your WordPress website with OBS Studio and WpStream. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and let us know what you want to see next. See you next time.